And to all you people back in the Shire, turn your porch lights off because we're coming home with a trophy.
Hey there, welcome to SharkCast, a podcast dedicated to the greatest sporting club in the history of the world, the mighty Cronulla Sutherland Sharks. The show is brought to you by Dyson Logistics, the Royal Motor Yacht Club in Port Hacking, and Jason Hawes at Cripps and Cripps Real Estate. My name is Sam Shinazzi, an OG from 2015. This is our 10th season of podcasting, having a ball along the way. Thanks to everyone who's been listening, tuning in, subscribing, following, writing in, etc., etc. We did not get to do a catching up with Kieran over coffee about Cronulla episode on Monday morning. He is on the road and unable to do so, but I do have a couple of interviews with some current Sharks players who I caught up with after training today. One of those is Dan Atkinson, playing a very important role in our season, and the other is Sione Katoa, the Tongan fisherman. So hope you enjoy those chats with those fellas. There's no news on Braden Trindle as I record. I did see him walking around. He doesn't have a limp. If he was to miss this week, which I think they're leaning towards, I would assume it's only precautionary, as in don't want to risk anything too soon after the awareness that he felt. That's what they were saying. He was aware of a feeling, maybe a little tweak or something. So they might play it safe and not play him on such a short turnaround, because if he was to do it again, it could be a lot more serious. If that's the case, I don't really have any intel on what the backup plan is. There's a few different options, as the coach said in his press conference. So wait to hear and see what happens on Tuesday team list. And even then, I think maybe there might be a bit of color and shade in that team list. So we'll see what the coach names, who he names. Big week for the Sharks, a somewhat must-win game. I think they're all must-win games from here on in, aren't they, to make the top four. Up against the Titans on the Gold Coast, a very tough trip this year, I think. Titans are in terrific form, scoring a lot of points, even when they lose. And Dez Hasler really has them firing with guys like Kieran Foran leading the way and Jaden Campbell. And there's a whole list of dangerous weapons out there for the Titans, so we're going to have to be pretty good this week to beat them. Definitely have to be better than what we were against the Rabbitohs last week, which I address with Dan Atkinson and Sione Katoa in the interviews coming up. Will Kennedy plays his 100th game this week, which is a great milestone. Debuted in 2019, 100th game this week. The team will definitely get around him for that, and that will be another reason for them to do their absolute best to win this game. For guys like Will, who have contributed so much in such a short time at the club. Had a quick chat with Nico Hines, the King of Carrongbar. He didn't give me a return date, but he's walking pretty well. Starts running pretty soon. And I think his return date, if everything trends the right way, might be sooner than we thought, which is positive. So wait and see on Nico Hines. I did congratulate him on becoming an author. He's got a kid's book coming out. It was just announced today as well. So that's cool to have people like him in that role model kind of position to be communicating with kids in particular is a real positive, I think. Looking at the remaining draw, we have Titans this week, 6 o'clock on a Friday. Then we come home Sunday week, 4 o'clock kickoff against the Knights. That'll be, I think, three grades. NRLW will be on before it, possibly Jersey Flag as well. That'll be a big day. If you're looking for a ticket for that game, I would get them sooner rather than later, because that will sell out Sunday afternoon. Then we have a derby, Sunday 25th of August in Wollongong, and that has become more of a challenge. And I think depending on what team we get to name that week, we'll be up for that challenge, but it's definitely a bit harder than what we probably envisioned a while ago. Then we have 31st of August, a Saturday night Warriors game at home, our home, and we finish up at Brookie against Manly on a Sunday afternoon. So winnable games there, but you really want to be knocking over the Knights and the Warriors at home. And if we can get one against the Titans or Dragons, that'd be beautiful. And then the Brookvale game will be the challenge that it always is. We have won there in recent times, which is great. We'll see what needs to be done, because maybe both teams, maybe one team won't be playing for much. They might not field their regular team. So obviously a long way out to round 27. But until we get there, I think that's about all I have. Thanks to everyone who tuned into our live stream on Saturday night after the South game. It was a lot of fun with the birthday boy, Gary Dover. We will be doing that whenever we get the chance. The chances aren't every week, unfortunately, but we still will get some shows to you as soon as we can after each game. Really appreciate everyone with their communication, just writing in, and great to meet. We met a bunch of people on Saturday night at the game, which was great that we hadn't met, and listeners of the show. So thank you to everyone who reached out. I really appreciate it. Keep supporting us and we'll support you. We do definitely appreciate it on behalf of everyone. Coming up, we have Dan Atkinson and Sione Katoa. Some interviews with them. I hope you enjoy the chats I had with them. A couple of other guys were available, but then they had meetings to get to and that kind of thing. So a few less interviews this week to choose from. But I certainly enjoyed my time with the two players and I thank them. Have a good week. We'll talk to you as soon as we can. This is SharkCast Pod. Talk to you soon. Up, up. Dan Atkinson here with SharkCast Pod. How did you pull up after the game?
Yeah, no, I pulled up all right. Obviously, the body's a bit sore. It was a bit of a weird game, to be honest. A lot of errors. But I thought the body's a bit sore just from the amount of defending we did on our line, which is obviously a good way to look at it because we turned them away a lot.
Yeah, defence was good. There were a lot of errors, which you mentioned, and the whole world could see that. I thought in a strange way it was a good build-up towards the end of the year, which I know you're not thinking about yet, but to play such a sort of defensive-orientated game. Does that make any kind of sense to you?
Yeah, no, definitely. I know what you're saying. Fitzy sort of touched on that too. It's obviously, we're going to make errors. It's footy. Everyone's going to make an errors when fatigue kicks in and everything, but it's how you bounce back on the back of that. So for us to defend our errors, I think that was a huge step forward.
How do you think the attack went?
Yeah, the attack was alright, a bit scrappy at times, but once we got it in the groove, like I pushed that pass. When you look back, you think, oh, maybe I'll just run it or something. But
which pass are you talking about?
Just the quarterback forward pass, oh, yeah. The one to Sione. But yeah, I think once we clicked, and yeah, it showed.
Any word on Trindle yet?
Nah, no word. Sorry.
Keep our eyes to the team sheet this week. We have the Gold Coast on Friday, so short-ish turnaround. They're in pretty good form. They score a lot of points. What's the emphasis this week?
Yeah, it's credit to them. They are playing good footy, but I think the more we focus on them, the less we focus on us. So I think this week's just going to be focusing on us and how we can take what we did good and what we did bad against the Rabbitohs and move forward and get better.
Is there anything you can tell me aside from improving the errors that we can work on?
I think just a connection and just moving forward. I think, like I said earlier, when we had to D our line, the scramble and everything, I think that was something to really be proud of. So I think it's just those errors and just building pressure.
What's it like for you playing at Shark Park? It was a full house. Fun for you running out and seeing all the fans?
Yeah, it's hectic, hey? When we first run out, do some kicking and catching and seeing the crowd and the atmosphere, yeah, it definitely gets you excited.
You mentioned off-air that you have family up in Queensland. Can you remind me, Dan, just briefly, where you're from?
Yeah, from Brizzy, and then moved Sunny Coast.
So you're going to see a lot of family up there?
Yeah, hopefully they'll make the drive down, which will be good, see some familiar faces and that.
How's the family adjusted to their son making the ranks of NRL regularly these days?
It's good. I think a dad calls me most days, and it's just good to see how happy I make him and mum and my brother. I think you can get caught up in focusing on footy, but then when you see like the raw emotion on their faces and that, yeah, it's a pinch yourself moment.
Did your dad play, or do you have a big interest in the game?
Yeah, he played. He played all the way growing up. Played at Valley's Diehards. He was my coach for a lot of the way growing up. Obviously my biggest mentor, and then my brother played also. He played at North Devils, Colts, got in the Bronx 20 system, and yeah, he's been a big help to me too.
All right, I appreciate your time. Good luck this week.
Thank you.
Thanks, Dan.
Appreciate it.
All right, SharkCast Pod with Sione Katoa. Welcome back to the show, my friend. You like scoring tries. It's going pretty good. Good win on the weekend. A very defence-orientated game for most of it. What do you think we can improve on moving forward?
Yeah, like you said, it was very good defence on the weekend. Probably could have added some attack there where we could have scored more tries. Maybe I could have got more, but yeah, made more attack.
Were you happy with the defence?
Yep. I was really happy with that one stage that we did up on the try line for, can't remember how many sets, but yeah, it was really good.
How do you think a team's looking moving towards the finals? I know you're only 1 week at a time, but how do you think we're going at the moment? We're on the improve?
Yes, on the improve. In the next couple of weeks, we can, you know, connect even more as a team and come final times ready to go.
A tough trip up to the Gold Coast, a short turnaround. They like to score a lot of points. As a team, how are we going to address the Titans game?
Yeah, probably defense. Like, they've got some strike plays on their edges, and probably defense will win this week.
Now, I should know this, but I can't remember. Who are you up against on the wing?
Khan Pereira.
I want to see you score some tries against him. What do you think about him? It's been a pretty big rise for him.
No, he's been scoring a lot of tries lately. Yeah, very fast. Just calling his name out a lot on the weekend and just not giving him any space.
How are you going personally? How are you feeling physically, mentally? How are you going?
Yep, really good. Physically, mentally, very good. After the game on the weekend, you know, even better.
How's the fishing going?
Fishing, bit cold last week. Was sick the week after. But yeah, try to go out as much as I can, you know.
Can you tell us about some spots? Some of our listeners are fishermen and fisherwomen. Give me some spots around the Shire. What's some of your haunts?
Probably if you want to get some lobsters, Shark Island there, around the rocks, not too far off. And fishing, not too sure, probably going me baths.
Sione, before you go, can I ask you about what you like to listen to music-wise? What are you into at the moment? What do you like? What's on around the house?
A bit of everything, country, R&B, drill music. I'm listening to a lot of drill music lately.
Can you explain to me what that is?
Just, you know, boys that grew up in western suburbs or wherever, like low hoods, and they just rap about what they've been through in life, yeah.
Okay. And what are we calling it? Drill music?
Drill music.
Okay. I've learned something today, Sione. Thanks for your time. Good luck on Friday.
Thank you.
Appreciate you. Thank you.
Shire, turn your porch lights off because we're coming home with a trophy.